Hello, my name is Veerle Haverals, and I work for the University of Antwerp, Belgium. This ILSA project video will give you an overview on how to train the speech recognition for specific terms that might be needed in the interlingual context, such as the use of short forms and or docs and macros. We continue to build on what you have learned in the previous modules, that is, the modules on subtitling, on simultaneous interpreting, and on intralingual respeaking. If you find that the speech recognition doesn't render a name or a term correctly, you will have to find a way to help the system. All respeakers develop their own system and have their own preferences. Some respeakers will barely use their keyboard. Others use it quite often. The first group will choose to work with macro or docs method. Opting for this method means that you teach your speech recognition phrase, for instance, that when you pronounce docs Holland or Holland macro, the name of François Hollande must appear in the written text, rather than the region known as Holland. You saw an example on this in the previous ILSA video. If you belong to the other group and like to work with your keyboard, you can also opt for a short form. Many subtitling programs allow you to make such a list of short forms. The system works in a similar way to the using macros, max or docs. For example, if you have prepared a list of short forms and your list contains the abbreviation FH linked to François Hollande, the name of François Hollande will appear whenever you type FH. And then press the space bar. A word of caution. Do not use either macros docs or short forms too much, and only use them for terms and names that often appear in your speech. It is also good practice to carefully consider, after a respeaking session, which short forms and macros will remain useful for a next assignment and which ones had better to be removed. For example, if you have used a macro for the title of the book that was the subject of a presentation, Docs Book or Bookmak, to become Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, it is best to remove that macro afterwards. That way, you can use DocsBook or Bookmak again for a subsequent speech about another book. If you find out in course of an assignment that you have not added a given name to your lexicon, you have two options. Either try to bypass the names by, for example, mentioning the function of the person, for example, Donald Trump, the President of the United States. Or quickly type the name, running the risk that you spell the name incorrectly, of course. In this part, you'll be creating lists of words that might create confusion in the speech recognition software. Having done this and having created solutions, you need to check if every solution is working. This is a generally accepted way to avoid language problems. Let's say that speakers' names are pronounced with an accent in the source language. In that case, you either have to train yourself to respeak those names in the way you would pronounce them in the target language, or adapt your language model in the speech recognition model to accommodate the foreign pronunciation. Hereby an example. Former President François Hollande came to Belgium for a visit. It's pronounced in Dutch, without saying François Hollande, but typing the short form FH.
oud-president was op bezoek in België, punt.